You'd never pick this gentle 86-year-old as one of the most outspoken critics of the Catholic Church, in particular, its treatment of women. She's been a Benedictine nun for 70 years. She got the calling early.
My father died just before I was three. My mother insisted on taking me to the funeral parlor, but I was distracted. Down here were two of the strangest looking creatures I had ever seen in my life. And I said to my mother in her ear, "What's that?" And my mother said, "Those are sisters, Joan. And when the angels come tonight for Daddy's soul, they'll say, take him straight to God." Whoa! That was like burned across. What a job! Fantastic!
She took her vows as a 16-year-old in a Pennsylvanian convent.
I was formed in beautiful concepts and care, and it touched me all my life. And when I see what's going on, I say to myself, we must do better.
She's written more than 50 books, has won numerous awards, and has been a guest on several TV shows, including Oprah.
Why the Benedictine order?
Well, the Benedictines are the oldest religious order in the Catholic Church. So you can't say they aren't tried and true, Molly. We are still using as our daily rule the rule of Saint Benedict from the 6th century, and it's a little book that's about 20 pages long. It works.
As much as she's attracted to tradition, she believes the Church and the Benedictines need to adapt to an ever-changing society.
Fairy tale religion is over. You simply cannot, you can't tell those stories anymore.
Right, but what is then left of the order?
Well, the order is, honey, we are still living on a little book.
I just can't believe a nun called me honey. No, this has never happened before in my life.
I had so many kids just like you, Walter.
Really?
In the junior American history class, right. And I loved them to death.
Sister Joan was shocked when a recent meeting of Australian Catholics initially voted to reject two proposals for the advancement of women in the Church.
How do you assess the place of women in the Catholic Church at the moment?
The place? There is no place. It's a joke. It's a pious lie. Because right now, you have half the human race that's being ignored.
Ignored in what way?
Well, ignored in every way. This whole notion that my life and your life are the same is nonsense. I get you, love you, Wally, you're gorgeous. But your view of life and my view of life are not the same. But when the rules are made, they'll call you.
Well, they won't call me.
Well, then you should understand my position.
Well, I have less of a stake, perhaps, than you do.
Do not separate yourself from this mentality just because you aren't Catholic. You are walking the streets of Australia, yeah, where women are paid less than men for the same job you do. And you haven't protested it yet. Until that happens, there is a huge gap between us. It's an immoral gap, and it is anything but religious. What you have right now is a male world, which means that this world is running on one eye, one ear, and one half the human mind, and it shows.
Sister Joan firmly believes that if more women were in decision-making roles, the world would have less of a problem with major scourges such as war, inequality, and racism, or ethnicity, as she puts it.
What do you mean by ethnicity?
Well, that will die out. It's white men who are having a problem with you, not white women. Now, when they finally gave black men the vote in the United States, they gave it to them before they gave the vote to white women. So there's clearly a pyramid here of difference and distinction and rejection. The women are sick and tired of being exalted on Mother's Day and ignored the day after. I mean, you're wonderful, you're glorious, you're the keeper of the human race. These women, what would we do without them? Maybe learn something. We've asked you, we've told you, we have explained to you, and I don't want my daughter growing up in this. I will not allow her to be taught anymore that she is inferior because God made her that way and God wants her that way.
How high would you like to see women rise within the church? Do you want a female pope?
To be quite frank, Wally, I consider that a corny question.
Sure, why?
Well, I don't put people on clerical ladders. I'm looking for fullness. I'm looking for a theology that says God made women and men equal. Work it out.
The other issue I want to talk to you about is the celibacy of priests. The current pope has maintained it and described celibacy as a gift to the church. Do you agree with him?
Well, I believe it can be a gift and is a gift to the true celibate. I'm just not sure how you impose a gift.
The scandal that has engulfed the Catholic Church has been to do with child sex abuse, and very often that a line is drawn between that and the celibacy of priests. Do you accept that connection?
No, I do not believe that the sex abuse crisis is a result of celibacy. I mean, we had a lot of very healthy male priests who were sex abusers. So am I to say then that married men are by nature sex abusers? That's ridiculous.
You're 86 now?
I am.
How long can you keep going?
Well, if you want to know how long you'll have to put up with me, probably not much longer. But isn't that fun? I don't know. I mean, I'm just not, it's a number to me.
Sister Joan, thank you.
Oh, thank you. You're a patient man, Mom.
Legend. So interesting, that idea of celibacy is a gift for some, but you can't impose a gift.
Yeah.
So if you feel it's a gift for you, then that's what right for you. But the idea that you tell someone else that they should do it and they should think it's a gift, that then puts a restriction on a person that's going to make them act in a certain way that isn't right for them. Very interesting.
It is.
My favourite line. You work it out.